Now, here's the asteroid story. An asteroid the size of the Rose Bowl, more than 1,000 feet across, fields its way toward the Earth right now. It'll come by first in 2029, and we'll see it up there. It'll be closer than our satellites, a thing the size of the Rose Bowl hurtling through the air. And then it comes again in 2036, and that's when it may get interesting. The debate over just how close it'll get is sparking some serious debate between Russian scientists and American scientists. Here's a satellite picture of the thing. This is from, well, with this and, you know, this tells you nothing. But see it there? I don't know, that circly thing in the middle maybe? This was from 2004. It doesn't look very intimidating here. Both sides seem to agree that in three decades, the asteroid will fly very close to Earth. But Russian scientists warn that our planet's gravity could change the asteroid's path and set it on a collision course. NASA scientists say there is a minuscule little bitty chance of that happening. One in 250,000. Better than winning the lotto, and somebody will. Well, joining us now, Michio Kaku. He's a theoretical physics professor at City University of New York, CUNY. He's also the author of Physics of the Future and a new book coming out in about a month, and we'll tell you about that in about a month. So, good to see you. Mm-hmm. 2029, it flies by underneath the satellites.
That's right. Mark it on your calendar. Friday the 13th, April 2036.
That's the second pass.
On the second pass, right. The first pass, like you said, it comes right underneath our satellites. You can actually see it whizzing right overhead.
Wow.
And on the second pass, it might actually be a nation buster. It'll take out Germany. It'll take out France, England.
Not England.
Right. Or the entire northeast of the United States.
Careful.
It'll hit with the force of 100,000 Hiroshima bombs.
Really? If it hits.
If it hits, right. It's a catastrophe beyond human comprehension. And the head of the Russian Space Agency has said that the Russian scientists should think of some ways of deflecting it or handling this
What are we going to do? Shoot it with a laser?
Well, everyone thinks we'll send Bruce Willis out there with the space shuttle. But the space shuttle can't even reach outer space. We're phasing it out, and the space shuttle only spins wheels around the planet Earth. It cannot even go to deep space. We need a new booster rocket to take us out there.
Maybe China will build us one.
Maybe, and then we have to nudge it out of the way. The farther it is, the easier it is to push it out with rockets so it'll miss the planet Earth. But it's something that we have to take seriously. This is the first major threat from a giant meteor or asteroid.
Were it to hit us, do we know what it would do to our rotation around the sun and the spinning on the axis?
Well, it will definitely affect the rotation of the Earth as it goes around the sun. The immediate impact would be of a gigantic shock wave going out maybe 50 to 100 miles, then firestorms going out to hundreds of miles beyond that.
Firestorms.
And then meteorites raining back down on the planet Earth. So the devastation would be on the order of 500 to 1,000 miles. Think of a bullseye containing half the United States. That's the potential impact. And again, it's a very tiny probability, but we're watching it very carefully.
Because the thinking among some of these Russian scientists is that the first time it passes, the gravitational pull of the Earth could pull it closer, and then on the second pass in 2036,
the wild card is also the atmospheric disturbances. It's going to come right to the outskirts of our own atmosphere. Friction is going to take place, and that's unpredictable. We simply don't know how it's going to react as it whizzes through the atmosphere of the Earth, and that could affect the second pass, and that's why we're keeping our fingers crossed in 2036.
Two sets of fingers crossed. But isn't the world ending in 2012? The Mayan calendar seems to indicate.
Well, if you look at the Mayan calendar, it actually says that it's cyclical, and we could be witnessing a rebirth. We should be celebrating then. And personally, I hope to be around in 2013. So don't sell the store. Don't get divorced. don't ruin your life in 2012.
All right. I'm sure some people will. News from the future. 2012 is going to be weird. It's great to see you.
Mm-hmm.
I'll see you in a month for that new book, right?
Right. Physics of the Future, about the next 50 to 100 years.
I can't wait. He interviewed 300 scientists. Now, here's the asteroid story. An asteroid the size of the Rose Bowl, more than 1,000 feet across, fields its way toward the Earth right now. It'll come by first in 2029, and we'll see it up there. It'll be closer than our satellites, a thing the size of the Rose Bowl hurtling through the air. And then it comes again in 2036, and that's when it may get interesting. The debate over just how close it'll get is sparking some serious debate between Russian scientists and American scientists. Here's a satellite picture of the thing. This is from, well, with this and, you know, this tells you nothing. But see it there? I don't know, that circly thing in the middle maybe? This was from 2004. It doesn't look very intimidating here. Both sides seem to agree that in 3 decades, the asteroid will fly very close to Earth. But Russian scientists warn that our planet's gravity could change the asteroid's path and set it on a collision course. NASA scientists say there is a minuscule little bitty chance of that happening. 1 in 250,000. Better than winning the lotto, and somebody will. Joining us now, Michio Kaku. He's a theoretical physics professor at City University of New York, CUNY. He's also the author of Physics of the Future and a new book coming out in about a month, and we'll tell you about that in about a month. So, good to see you. Mm-hmm. 2029, it flies by underneath the satellites.
That's right. Mark it on your calendar. Friday the 13th, April 2036. On the second pass, right? The first pass, like you said, it comes right underneath our satellites. You can actually see it whizzing right overhead.
Wow.
And on the second pass, it might actually be a nation buster. It'll take out Germany. It'll take out France, England.
Not England.
Right. Or the entire northeast of the United States.
Careful.
It'll hit with the force of 100,000 Hiroshima bombs.
Really? If it hits,
right. It's a catastrophe beyond human comprehension. And the head of the Russian Space Agency has said that the Russian scientists should think of some ways of deflecting it or handling this
What are we going to do? Shoot it with a laser?
Well, everyone thinks we'll send Bruce Willis out there with the space shuttle. But the space shuttle can't even reach outer space. We're phasing it out, and the space shuttle only spins wheels around the planet Earth. It cannot even go to deep space. We need a new booster rocket to take us out there.
Maybe China will build us one.
Maybe, and then we have to nudge it out of the way. The farther it is, the easier it is to push it out with rockets so it'll miss the planet Earth. But it's something that we have to take seriously. This is the first major threat from a giant meteor or asteroid.
Were it to hit us, do we know what it would do to our rotation around the sun and the spinning on the axis?
It will definitely affect the rotation of the Earth as it goes around the sun. The immediate impact would be a gigantic shock wave going out maybe 50 to 100 miles, then firestorms going out to hundreds of miles beyond that.
Firestorms.
And then meteorites raining back down on the planet Earth. So the devastation would be on the order of 500 to 1,000 miles. Think of a bullseye containing half the United States. That's the potential impact. And again, it's a very tiny probability, but we're watching it very carefully.
Because the thinking among some of these Russian scientists is that the first time it passes, the gravitational pull of the Earth could pull it closer, and then on the second pass in 2036,
the wild card is also the atmospheric disturbances. It's going to come right to the outskirts of our own atmosphere. Friction is going to take place, and that's unpredictable. We simply don't know how it's going to react as it whizzes through the atmosphere of the Earth, and that could affect the second pass, and that's why we're keeping our fingers crossed in 2036.
Two sets of fingers crossed. But isn't the world ending in 2012? The Mayan calendar seems to indicate.
Well, if you look at the Mayan calendar, it actually says that it's cyclical and we could be witnessing a rebirth. We should be celebrating then. And personally, I hope to be around in 2013. So don't sell the store, don't get divorced, don't ruin your life in 2012.
All right, I'm sure some people will. News from the future, 2012 is going to be weird. It's great to see you.
Mm-hmm.
I'll see you in a month for that new book, right?
Right, Physics of the Future, about the next 50 to 100 years.
I can't wait. He interviewed 300 times.